Today, we are going to discuss affordable icons. That's correct. Those two words are going together. Beautiful people, what's happening? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. First off, if you have not subscribed, happy to have you here. Welcome back. We upload daily, every single day. Energy is feeling uplifting today in particular. Why? I have no idea. We got that positive nature. If you want more videos discussing icons, I'm talking ASAP, please drop a like. High key appreciated, and this is gonna get debatable. I picked 10 names, I did that on purpose. We're stirring the conversation. If you're making changes or shifts or you're swapping players in and out, let me know who's moving where. I always see in the comment section you bring up different player names, but you don't tell me who's getting replaced. Don't cop out. Lean into it. Criteria, only icons, 250K to 500K. I already did a cheap version of this video. That's going to be under 250. We got the in-between stage. That's why it's affordable. One version of any of these players, maximum and performance-based. I'm not taking into consideration the value based on the price point, but you do have that limitation or the price restriction. I went over it. Let's begin. Shout out to the goalkeepers. I just want to give them a mention because I don't want to include them into my top 10, but Yashin, Van der Sar, Petrček, Schmeichel, if you can afford any of these gentlemen, or if they fit into your squad properly, I believe in them. I backdoor them. I would probably be a little more of a skeptic or stay away from Casillas just from a size perspective, but I wanted to give their own little separate sectioned off area so we can really talk about the on the pitch players. I guess technically these guys would also be on the pitch. Your outfield players. Lam. I wish he wasn't a left back, but he is so quick, and he's got those top tier defensive statistics. We're talking even if he was a center back, these would stand out. Those numbers are legitimate. The issue or the concern, not only is he only at a 3-star weak foot and you're playing him on the left side unless you're swapping him over. At least initially he's playing on the left side. You can do what you want to do. But he's got that body type, that framework, that structure that I personally do not love. The movement, incredible. The stamina, unforgiving. He's up and down the wing all match long, but he's gonna feel a little more like that Navas. If you use the fullback version, he's a better variation. I should say wingback. He's still an improvement, but body type wise, that will have a similarity, and I don't love that. Don't have the strength, don't have the physical specimen. You're not making contact. Well, he's not winning a lot of those altercations. But if it's time to perfection, properly get a foot onto it, there's no doubt that you're gonna get stuck in. Also, a precise passer and facilitator, which I high key respect. Overmars, equal footed. And I feel he's still slept on, going to bed early at night or waking up too soon. And he's one of the few 3-star skill move attackers that I respect, that I believe in the expression, that I can coordinate with. If I was gonna start a company, LLC, S Corp, traditional corporation, even a partnership of some sort or a sole proprietorship, I can go into business with Overmars. And he's definitely a track star. I don't remember if that was Fetty Wap or not. He's just relentless down the wings. And I score a lot of goals with him. I always have. He's been one of those outlet players that I've enjoyed using over the course of the years. And because he doesn't carry as big of a name, maybe not as significant or well-recognized as he really deserves, you typically can get him for a pretty decent evaluation or a valued pickup. Even though, I would like to reiterate, this list is not based on that initiative or equation, the foot equation. Pirlo! Just so happy to have him in FIFA. And the big shift here is going from a 77 to an 84 stamina between the baby and the mid version shifts this foot item completely. Makes it much more usable, viable, got that clutch factor. Because if you're playing him as a center mid, whether he's gonna be more balanced, a holding mid, even an attacking mid, I need him to last. We know the passing is at a legendary level, but you add in those 5-star skills, a lean body type, high key dribbling all over the virtual pitch, first touches that are tastes good. You have this strange hybrid of a player. Doesn't have to sit deep and spray the ball out wide. He can get more so into those attacking positions. Make those key splitting passes. Help you be a little more prolific. I wish I had a glass of wine. Cheers. Right here. Right now. The dribbling and the passing combination is just dumb. Or it's smart. It's unmatched in many ways. They go hand in hand. In this case, foot and foot. seems more appropriate. I rate Pirlo. There will be some sort of learning curve. He's kind of an unusual player. Stoichkov! And the theme today seems to be overlooked icons. Hence why the price points are in this mid-tier, this affordable range, at least if we're looking at iconic players. Striker, not on the wings this time. And he's fitting for those deliverables. Always enjoyed his finesse shot. You open up that body, it's got that extra dip. A little more swerve, a little more movement. I score a lot of goals again with Stoichkov. And he's got a body type that's not too big, but it's not small. It's not one of those lean, mean fighting machines. I say that because he's kind of aggressive. And I win a lot of those interactions or conversations, discussions. I'm the loud guy in the room. And Stoichkov can bump off some defenders or holding midfielders or players just tracking back in general. Does have the 3-star weak foot. That's a little bit of a detriment, but I'll leave that here. Didier Drogba. You can pick which version you like. I'm going with the 87. Relates to yours truly the most. And I've talked about this previously, but he's a brick house. He's a rhino. Physicality, unparalleled. Especially when we're looking at strikers. Players just bump off of him. True target man status. One of the greatest strikers of all time. At least if you're asking me. And in this case, I am asking myself, and then I'm expressing that on camera. Always been dynamic. In FIFA, maybe not quite the same. But in terms of the hold-up play, the finishing, and also long shooting. You see that powerful Drogba shot? Doesn't he need to be a finesse? It hits the back corner. It's got that extra lift. We're talking Drogba on the elevator going to the top floor, the rooftop view. Late at night, sunset, sunrise. Technically, that could be very late at night or very early in the morning. Either way, Drogba's a problem. And if you're going up against somebody who's using him, they know what to do. They understand what he's good at, how to use and abuse. And you're going to be receiving. There's no doubt about that. Drogba is the provider. Shuker! Always a surprise unless you've seen my videos or watched me put this guy into motion via Twitch in the live stream. And I just rate him. He talks to me. Then I answer, and then he replies. I'm never getting left on read. We're having a fantastic equal text conversation, mutual relationship. This is starting to get strange for the comparisons. But I really like Shuker. Whether he's finding the open man, I'm cutting into space, I'm playing him as a center forward, false nine. Even on the wings or the attacking mid, I just used him in so many different roles, and I kind of feel as if he's able to have this utility approach to the attacking positions on the virtual pitch, and I'm not having a fall off. He's got that extra iconic sauce. I'm not talking about barbecue or ranch. In fact, I don't like ranch. If you've had Chick-fil-A, they have this Polynesian sauce. Oof. It's sweet, but you're going to remember it in a positive manner. Haji! I would say on a stock increase. And Owe has to appreciate this. The Romanian God card. And you can score bangers. I want to emphasize that. Not only is left-footed, which just makes them smoother in general. Lefties do it better. But 87 curve, 91 long shots, 94 shot power. That's all legitimate. And he's slippery. He's going to find those angles. Dexterity is where you'd like it to be. And again, the first touches, the control, that cannot be taught. You either have it or you don't. And Haji, indeed, has mastered that. He's grasped it. And if you give him an opportunity, not even with goal scoring, but just to be one of your attacking playmakers or a number 10 or some center attacking mid role, I think you'll be impressed. He'll definitely move into your top 10 when you're going into icons. Nedved! Does he hold a special place in my heart? Perhaps. Is this a biased choice? Perhaps. Have I been putting in work with him for multiple years now? Indeed, no lies should be detected. Put me on the lie detector, polygraph me up. Nedved is fantastic. And he has this allocation of statistics and the activations and the deliverables are all real, authentic, genuine. One of my favorite players of all time on the actual pitch as well. And the way that he's able to be a winger or be a secondary striker or a center attacking mid, he can fit into multiple roles seamlessly. That gives you competitive advantage. And you're going to trust them. Both feet again. Cutting inside, attacking the wings, the crossing, the facilitation, the switching of the pitch, the passing, the vision. You name it, he can do it. He's achieved it. Believe it. Zambrada might be a little bit of a surprise, but he's trusted, reliable. I don't think I'm being conservative. You want a lockdown fullback, you have one. And he has that 5-star weak foot, so actually playing a righty on the left side of the pitch, not really an issue. Just comes down to what you're looking for. I've also had him scoot into a center mid or a holding mid role. Has the track record, which I cannot stress enough. When we're talking about players that have success stories in FIFA over multiple years, the key word there is multiple years. Zambrada has that. and consistency is key. Are there exceptions to the rule? No doubt. But it is rare to see a player be top tier 1 year and then fall off the next. That's just not been a common theme in FIFA if the statistical allocation is the same or similar. Body types don't shift. We're not doing new motion capture for these icons. If you like what they're bringing to the table, then you better eat the appetizer, enjoy the main course, and stay put for dessert. And take an espresso to go. These are Italians that we're discussing here. Need that re-up on the energy. Number one, for me, it's Maldini. I know he's a left back. You could play him there. I would recommend using him as a center back. Please do not come in with the negativity. Maldini was always meant to be a center back. I already know what you're going to say, what you're thinking. That's rat tactics. Fullbacks and center backs, is that the message that you're promoting? Michael? Not necessarily, but he has 65 dribbling. That's not what you want from a fullback, but it's okay from a center back. 87 and 87 for the acceleration and the sprint speed. The strength is cool. The stamina is cool. The defending, phenomenal. One of the best center backs or defensive players of all time, if not the greatest. 90 on a default foot item. Interceptions, heading accuracy, defensive awareness, standing tackle, sliding tackle, everything is a 90 plus. Before a chemistry style. You can't deny that. 6'1", body type is where you want it to be. Passing out of the back, not a liability. Do I care about goal scoring? No, I do not. And I can't stress it enough that he's just built better to be a center back when you're looking at some of the lower dribbling numbers, because we rely on those fullbacks to set the tempo, to push the attack forward. At least I do. That's the video. Let me know what you think. Agree? Disagree? Are you somewhere in between? Are players moving around? Some going up, some going down. Perfect. We have discussion points. If you want more icon content, make sure to drop a like. It's free to subscribe, and I have a lot more coming out ASAP.